Shah.
And I'm Natalia.
Welcome to Cherry on Top. Now, today we're going to show you how we made this beautiful ginger cake, one of our favorite holiday recipes.
And to accompany this traditional dessert, we're going to show you how we made a cranberry fizz. With this easy, refreshing summer drink, I can guarantee your guests will have a more delicious one.
Okay, we have all our ingredients ready for our ginger forest cake. Natalia, are you ready?
Yes.
I love what you've done.
It's amazing.
Okay, so first of all, we're going to start by cleaning up 125 grams of butter. And it's been out for a while now, so it should be nice and soft.
Could you pass a spoon, please?
Yeah, sure. Okay, so that seems to have melted up nice. So now we need some vanilla essence, just about a teaspoon of vanilla essence.
Mmm, it smells so good.
I know, it's gonna taste so good. Okay, now that the butter is all mixed up, it's time to add the brown sugar.
Why are we using brown sugar?
Well, the reason why we're using brown sugar is because brown sugar goes really well with spice cakes. It has that really nice, rich brown color. Plus, it's healthier than white sugar. Mm-hmm. So we just add about half a cup. There we go. Okay, now we need to add one egg. Crack one up. Nice and smooth. Okay, while you make that nice and fluffy, I'm going to come over here and work on our dry ingredients.
Yeah, I'm going to make some more space.
Okay, sure. Alright, so what we have here is some self-raising flour, and we need about 2.5 cups of this. And self-raising flour is good for our cake because it's going to make it nice and poofy. So let's get that in there.
So what we're going to do next?
Now we're going to add in our ground ginger, which is our star ingredient.
So, can we use other spices?
Yeah, you definitely can use other spices. You can use cinnamon powder, you can use nutmeg, you can use cloves. They all add some extra flavor, and you can use how much ever you want. So we need about 3 tablespoons of brown ginger. Just like that. And now we need just 1 teaspoon of baking powder. And finally, to add some flavor to the cake, we just want to add a little pinch of salt. Now, of course, we want to mix all that up. So we're getting a sifter here. And just shake it up. We're going to leave this till the end. So first we're going to finish up with the butter mixture, and then in the end, once we've done with the sauce and everything, we can put in the flour. There we go. Our dry ingredients are finished. Okay, now it's time to add in our golden sauce to the butter mixture.
So what exactly is golden sauce?
Well, normally when you go to the store and you buy a golden sauce, it's full of sugars and artificial flavoring that we don't really want in our cake, and we want it to be homemade. So what we've done here is we've made some golden sauce out of 1/2 cup of brown sugar, 1/2 cup of water, and bits of caramel, vanilla essence. You can just add in whatever you want. And we just mixed it up and brought it to a boil, so it just thickens up into like caramel consistency. And yeah.
Wow, I never knew about this.
Yeah.
It looks nice.
It tastes really good, and it smells a bit of ginger too.
I can feel it.
So the main thing which makes our golden sauce different is that we added in some ginger, fresh ginger, into the sauce. So let's add that in. You can see the color is a lot like caramel, which is exactly what we want. And caramel goes really well with ginger. Never thought you'd put ginger in a cake, did you? Make sure you use all that flavor. You can see the little bits of ginger in there. So when you bite into the cake, you can feel that bit of spiciness.
So how much ginger do you need?
Just about half a tablespoon. Because you don't want your cake to be too spicy as well.
I never use ginger for cake.
It's great for holidays, especially Christmas. So mix that up. Okay, you just mix that up. I'm gonna go put this in the sink.
Sure.
All right, now it's time for our flour and our milk. Just need about 1 cup of milk for this. Now, basically what we're gonna do is we don't wanna add everything all at once, otherwise it's gonna get all clumped in our cake. So what we're going to do is we're going to add just a little bit of flour. I feel like a true chef right now. Of course. So you can see the cake's getting a bit dry now. That's when you need to add the milk. Just a little more. Now don't get worried if your cake gets a bit watery, it's supposed to be like that. And when it does get watery, you just need to add more flour. Now you can see the color is becoming paler, which is the color that your cake's going to come out when it comes out of the oven. And add some more flour. Now you just need to keep doing this until the flour and the milk get. Make sure you get all the flour from the sides as well.
You're a good teacher.
Thanks. You would if you've made this cake 1,000 times before. Got all the milk in there. So just finish mixing that all up. I think it needs something. Crunch.
Oh, I can see the nuts there.
Oh yeah,
right here.
Our nuts. So we've got some sliced almonds, really crunchy and nice. In our cake. And once it's baking, it will get a little roasted. So
do we have to put the whole?
No, just a few. So that each bite has a good 2 to 3 nuts.